Folks in Louisiana brace for impact from Harvey the same way they did exactly 12 years ago with Hurricane Katrina.
Two storms that devastated entire cities, communities, but two storms that beyond that aren't at all the same. Chris Arabsky breaks down the tale of these two storms and the wakes each left behind.
This is just an unbelievable scene.
This is something we've never faced before.
Nature's wrath in two epic storms, 12 years apart. The setting. Katrina hit New Orleans, a city of roughly 500,000 people. Most of it sits in a bowl below sea level, protected by levee walls. Harvey hit Houston, a sprawling city of about 2 million people. It sits 80 feet above sea level. The storms. Katrina entered the Louisiana-Mississippi border as a Category 3 storm. It measured about 350 miles wide. It dropped just 5 to 10 inches of rain, but produced the highest storm surge ever in the U.S., breaking those levees.
One of the levees has broken.
Harvey hit the Texas Gulf Coast as a Category 4 storm, but quickly downgraded. It extended 200 miles across. But that storm continues to dump 50 inches of rain in some areas, a new record for any storm in the lower 48. The damage. Harvey's left about 300,000 people without power so far. Katrina left 3 million people without power. Katrina caused about $100 billion in damages. Economists predict Harvey might reach half that.
One of the largest disasters America has ever faced.
The death toll. Officials say 10 people have died as a result of Hurricane Harvey. Katrina was responsible for 1,833 deaths, the third deadliest hurricane in American history. Assistance. Hurricane Katrina displaced 1 million people. Roughly that many received assistance from FEMA. In all, more than 250,000 homes were either damaged or destroyed. For Harvey, flooding continues. Rescues continue. The devastation, not totally quantifiable yet. FEMA officials estimate about 500,000 people are likely to seek aid.
And another big difference between those storms were mandatory evacuations.
Right.
The people of New Orleans were ordered to evacuate, and about 100,000 people were actually left behind, which created that whole story of the slow rescue and hard to get places and people, and the images we can't forget. There was no mandatory evacuation for Houston this time. There was, however, though, for Rita,
yep,
which was right after Katrina, and like 100 people died in Houston just trying to flee the city. So
yeah, that was the lesson learned by Houston with this storm. Trying to evacuate 2 million people, even in 48 hours, is impossible.
Mm-hmm.
It clogs the roads and you get what you had with Rita. So there's only a bunch of bad options.
Well, and
for emergency management.
And in some ways, there's just no way to compare these sorts,
yes,
of things anyway. You know what I mean? Just the storms were so different. This one dumping 50 inches of rain, you know,
yeah,
that one just 10, you know, to 15 inches of rain.
Right.
But the damage that each one does is just so different.
And I don't think we're trying to say which one's worse. It's irresponsible. We're just trying to say how they're different because they're huge. They're impacting a ton of people and they're both really dangerous in their own right.
Yeah. Interesting story. Thank you, Chris.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.